Now we have our next matchup, Kings of Urban taking on Supersonic Avengers. And we're getting a little bit ready here to get into this match. So while we're getting everything good to go here, it is going to be very important to certainly discuss, you know, this particular matchup. Because we've got the number one team in North America, in Kings of Urban, who again also won the Hagewood Award earlier today for having the best record in the Pro League, going up against a team like Supersonic Avengers, who finished fourth overall, but is one of those teams that is really quite strong when it comes to their offensive performance and their overall performance just in general against a lot of different teams in not only the Pro League, but in general.
Yeah, historically, Supersonic Avengers has always been a kind of hit or miss team. When they show up, they really do show up, and they're going to smack you against the wall, and they're going to launch goal after goal after goal into the net. If they don't show up, then they're pretty lacking, and they're kind of give their opponents way too much freedom. So, if anything, tonight is one of those matches where Supersonic Avengers will have to show up, and they will have to show up big. This match is pretty much the exact opposite from the one we just saw, which was number one EU versus number four NA. This is number one NA versus number four EU. So, yeah, Supersonic Avengers, I really think that based on how strong of a team they are and how well they usually play and what level they are on, a number four finish in EU got to be a bit disappointing for them. Probably I certainly still would have expected higher from them, but they still made it to the playoffs and they've got a chance to make it to the semifinals. Just got to beat the best team in North America right now.
Yeah, it's true. And they are, you know, maybe they're going to be disappointed a little bit in the fact that they finished fourth, but they also know just how competitive EU is and how things can shift on a dime, quite frankly, when it comes to these different teams. And they had a very good season. They had a lot of good showings. Things didn't start off too well for them with an 0-5 start against Crown and Jewels, but they came back after that looking much more like the Supersonic Avengers were used to, quite frankly. And I think the biggest thing here in this particular matchup is really just they have to be able to shut down or deal with the offensive pressure that Supersonic Avengers brings because, you know, that is going to be probably the hardest thing for them to deal with. We know that the shot totals that SA brings are off the charts sometimes. The pressure they bring can be very hard to deal with. And as long as Kings of Urban can maintain their strong defense, maintain their composure against that, they stand a very good chance of being a very dominant team. And they've had a lot of good international showings.
They certainly did. So tonight's going to be game night for them. Let's see if we are going to get an EU versus EU first semifinal or an EU versus NA first semifinal. It's like the game that will decide that. And it's certainly going to be interesting to watch. Here we go. Kings of Urban on the blue side, Supersonic Avengers on the orange side. Any predictions coming into this one?
You know, this one's a little harder to say. I'll be honest with you. As we are getting ready here. Just because, like I said, it's that offensive pressure out of...
Oh!
So, yeah, as I'm
Speaking
saying
of...
that. Now we've got Kings of Urban starting to come out a little bit swinging here.
Another one by Jacob. Oh, jeez. Be the one that dunk it in. 13
well,
seconds and Kings of Urban coming out huge.
Yeah, very quickly. Fireburner playing that nicely off the wall. Jacob getting the response and then comes back in to help get the finish there. So that is, you know, quite frankly, that's what Kings of Urban needs to do. They have to respond with their own pressure and prevent Supersonic Avengers from peppering the net with a lot of shots and being that kind of overwhelming attack swarm, if you will, that they have been in the past. And if any team is capable of it, it's certainly Kings of Urban. They are one of the strongest, if not the strongest team in North America, and will prove to be the biggest obstacle for any European team, I think, that wants to win this event.
Yeah, true that. And they are putting all the pressure onto Supersonic Avengers pretty hard right now, keeping them in their own half of the field. Looking to build, like, a defensive wall down at the middle.
Oh,
and that's Jacob just
well,
cheekily redirecting that one off of the bounce. To
really well done. Look at Jacob here. He just parks his car knowing that there's probably going to be a rebound there. Good awareness on his part. He stops that, responds to it, and then just floats it into the net. A big 2-0 start here for Kings of Urban.
Absolutely. Amazing start for him. And Supersonic Avengers, they have struggled to get some any kind of tangible offense going so far. Breathing Master finally passing the ball way up front, but there's a quick lead from Jacob. We're not going to be able to save this one. Yes, they will. And they're looking for the counterattack here, but Maestro making sure that doesn't happen. Knocking the ball back up onto in front of the KOU goal. And this is Supersonic Avengers finally launching these types of attack and getting a goal out of it.
Yep, here we go. A little bit more about what we expected from Supersonic Avengers. Greasy playing that off the backboard to ELMP, who just ends up getting the right angle to get the finish there. But that was only a small glimpse of that whole offensive attack, which was just shot after shot, either being sent to the backboard, sent around the net, just applied in some way to really make life difficult for this team. So,
KOU quickly looking for the response here. Clearly, Jacob on the wrong side of the field still went for that ball. It was just going to go flying towards the blue goal.
Well, that worked out really well for Supersonic Avengers. Played forward by ELMP, and Greasy just gets that little sideswipe redirect with a lot of momentum behind it to put it away into the net and quickly tie this game up.
There's a lot of speed behind that ball. 80 miles per hour, I think that was. That's one grenade, but Fireburner is going to launch one of his own here. Gets cleared by ELMP. Jacob's going to try to get it back in front of the goal. Moses driving alongside it, looking for the opportunity to go in. Going to bounce it off the backboard. Unfortunately, both of his teammates have already retreated, or have they? Fireburner winning out the 50-50 there against Greasy Meister. Jacob going to try to keep the ball in the hot zone. Passes it straight over to Meister, who can get a wide clear, force Moses to make the save. So back and forth right now after a shaky start for Supersonic Avengers. Look like they have found their footing now and looking to make use of it. As Maestro tries to cheekily dribble that one. Goes against the wall in the end. Gives KOU the opportunity to go for a clear. Moses without playing Greasy Meister. They are not getting past the LMP though. Passes the ball back up front. Looking to apply some pressure here. As we are approaching halftime, this game is looking a lot more even than we would have expected just looking at the first 30 seconds. This might be a big opportunity for Supersonic Avengers. Greasy Meister gets his own setup.
Greasy slips this one past Moses. You can see the ball played up high here on the rebound. And then the follow-up shot just gets past the front end of Moses' car. And that's going to give Supersonic Avengers a nice go-ahead here. And very impressive showing by them here in the really the very beginning of this game, the first half, so to say, to respond to what looked like some overwhelming Kings of Urban pressure.
Yep. Pressure since then from Kings of Urban has certainly been there, but didn't quite hit the mark, as Supersonic Avengers did make the right defensive moves to prevent them from going in too hard. And Fireburner is going to get the ball snatched away from him. Greasy Meister bouncing it onto the wall. Ground, of course. Moses intervening there, knocking it back onto the orange side of the field. So KOU are certainly trying to make something happen here. Fireburner going to try to win out the 50-50 against Maestro, but just not succeed at it, because Supersonic Avengers defense is very much on point right now, and they're going to pass the ball up front any opportunity they can get. Both the goals, or all three of the goals from Supersonic Avengers, haven't been much in terms of team play. It was more of an individual effort, but if it works out for them, then, I mean, it doesn't matter how the goal goes in, as long as it is a goal, as long as the ball crosses that goal line. We're going to see Maestro almost set the ball up in front of the goal. ELMP was already hot on his way to try and pick up on that setup. Didn't quite make it happen. Supersonic Avengers keeping the ball on the blue side of the field. And KOU getting prompted to defend very heavily right now. They're going to get a wide clear. They're going to have to get a wide clear. They're going to have to get it soon. Or Supersonic Avengers is going to keep ramping up the pressure until they get shots like this one. Another one onto target. Finally, Jacob will get opportunity to try and dribble this one and pass Greasy Meister. Oh. And he does for the equalizer.
Yep, they're finally responding the way they need to against this Supersonic Avengers team. They get a good breakaway here, and Jacob plays it as far off Greasy as he can to get that in the net. And, again, that's all the sort of approach they need to take, because they are starting to deal with the heavy pressure that we know Supersonic Avengers is capable of bringing. And they've been bringing that. That's why they tied this game back up. I mean, that's why they got the lead, I should say. But, that's what Kings of Urban just has to fight off throughout this series.
Oh, Maestro putting one out to target. ELMP is going to go for the follow-up shot there. But KOU intervening before he can do that. We are in the final minute of the game, and right now it's looking like overtime. Both these teams really neck-to-neck, seeing eye-to-eye. Jacob's going to try to bounce this one in from the top. And Greasy Meister trying to juggle it for ELMP, but Fireburner gets the clear. Back onto the other side it goes. The the biggest game of ping pong imaginable, and now comes Maestro launching one at the target for a change. Greasy Maestro going to try to pick this one up from the corner, but Moses gets the clear, and Supersonic Avengers back home for the defense. 20 seconds KAU, still have to try and go into the lead here. They're certainly going to try to put up as much pressure as they possibly can. But with the clear, and the follow-up clear, and the likely follow-up clear... It's going to look like we're going to see an overtime of this match. Or will we? Jacob getting one. Oh, closely onto target and trying to get the follow-up.
No, we will not. Jacob helps put together a big play for Kings of Urban off the backboard here. And he just squeezes this one past Maestro, who can't quite get the contact he needs. Kind of helps put that one in. So a big goal from Jacob. That is going to give them that advantage with only 4 seconds to go. So unless Supersonic Avengers comes in with a game-saving overtime goal here.
They're setting one up.
Oh!
Fireburner! Wrong place, wrong time. That's the buzzer beater equalizer.
Greasy just plays this forward, and Fireburner helps put it in because he was on the wrong side of the ball, and we're going to overtime. Oh, already a huge start.
What a first game of this series. Supersonic Avengers looking to capitalize early on in the overtime. But gets blocked by KAU in the last possible moment. Supersonic Avengers, they basically just have to win this one now. Just carry of all that momentum into the second game. Very, very unfortunate touch from Fireburner there to call the game into overtime with 4 seconds left on the clock. Supersonic Avengers still scoring. Let's see who will win the golden goal. Greasy Maestro putting one on towards target. Moses clearing her way onto the side, but Maestro already waiting there for the wall hit. Going to bounce off the wall, but nobody from SSA there to pick up on the follow-up. And so Moses gets another clear, blows up Greasy Maestro. Fireburner doesn't quite get the angle that he was looking for there. He had an opportunity onto an empty goal.
Yeah, that couldn't was a big chance there. Big, big chance there, and unfortunately just couldn't quite put it on there. That was a good use of that demo, but then the target was just not there for Fireburner.
Yep, the ball is just... carefully being tapped on some people's roofs there. Nobody really wants to give up control at this point in the game. One goal is all that it takes to take that all-important first game in the series. Just gonna set some clocks here. And Jacob back in the corner. Greasy Maestro gonna try to follow this one up. ELMP waiting for the block. Doesn't quite win out the 50-50 against Moses though, which means KOU will be on the offense unless Maestro can get a definitive clear. He doesn't. Fireburner keeps it in the hot zone. Gonna try to go for this one. Gets blocked by ELMP. And Maestro getting a touch on the ball before Moses can. Now Jacob with a brick shock. Gonna get the double tap. No, not quite. Just missing it by mere inches. Huge chance for KOU though. They're gonna follow up on it. Moses just bounces the ball further up into the air. Both teams getting big opportunities, but not quite making use of them. Fireburner with another shot on the target. Gets saved by ELMP. And Greasy Maestro gonna try to carry this one instead of getting the wide clear. Fails at Fireburner. KUU definitely the more dominant team, or the more aggressive team in overtime so far.
So far, yeah, but the shots aren't going anywhere. They're getting a lot of great chances, but all it takes is one, and there could be the one, but no, Greasy just cuts that one off at the last moment. But they're turning it right back around. So much defense coming on the part of Supersonic Avengers to try to shut this down, and they did so very well, but they have to flip it around on the offense, and having a hard time doing that.
Going to bounce off the ceiling. ELMP looking to pick up on that. It's going to try to bounce it off the backboard. Hits the ceiling as well. Maestro getting in position just in case, but Fireburn was always going to get that clear. And now Supersonic Avengers, it's their turn to make some offensive moves. They're going to have to prevent this clear from Jacob. Maestro passing it back into the middle. Unfortunately, nobody from Supersonic Avengers was near that. So that's going to allow Kings of Urban to make the play on their own. And
Fireburn!
What a beautiful play for the overtime goal and the win.
Big goal here, but not sure what Greasy was doing. He didn't quite react to that. I want to try to get a better angle of it. He just wasn't pointed in the right direction. He was pointed forward and couldn't quite get his car where it needed to be to respond to that shot in time. And Kings of Urban having to really fight and claw their way to getting into there. But yep. They do manage to do it.
They do in the end. But man, oh man. Supersonic Avengers gave them one run for their money. That much is for certain. And I think that after this game, it's going to be pretty much impossible to really call which way this series is going to go. I had my money on Supersonic Avengers simply because I'm EU and I'm biased. But now with Kings of Urban, well, let's be honest, Kings of Urban, stat-wise, is expected to, was expected to win this one. If we just look at the stats, if we just look at the pure math. But Supersonic Avengers is such a huge performance. Talked about earlier how they show up when they show up, and boy, did they show up tonight.
They really have, and they're coming in here trying to be, you know, exactly that dominant NA team that a lot of people expected them to be. And Supersonic Avengers did not want to look like a fourth-place team at all.
Oh, no. Right off the bat.
Yeah, we got to watch this one again. You're going to see Fireburner gets his contact here, but it looks like just a bad attempt at clearing this out. It ends up flicking it backwards. And that's going to allow Kings of Urban to open up the scoring here. So not the way to start for Supersonic Avengers with that sort of goal, but that's a good way to respond.
That was even 2 seconds.
Didn't even need it. Look at this. Off the kickoff, sets it to Greasy. Greasy finishes the redirect. Jacob doesn't even know how to respond to that. And immediately we are tied up.
And that just continues the insanity that is this match. 1-1 after 15 seconds. Let's see if both teams can keep that one up. Kings of Urban certainly looking to apply some pressure here. Moses blowing up Maestro there. Greasy Maestro getting the rebound off of the wall. The LMP can't get his hands on it before Jacob does. And Maestro getting that all-important save. Fireburner getting one off onto target here. But Greasy Maestro had enough speed to come in from the side and go for the save. So Kings of Urban right now in the dominant position. But Supersonic Avengers is going to look for that opportunity. Wait for that one opportunity to get a control of the ball. Fireburner not quite able to redirect the ball into the goal there. Didn't quite see that ball coming. Did not quite expect that, I think. Maestro fading the dribble. At the last hurdle, Jacob takes the ball off of him. So again, neck and neck game.
Yeah, Firebird are not quite looking like the offensive, the effective attacker that he normally is, though, so far. I don't know how much that has to do with the server, or just how much that has to do with wherever he is right now. But I'm sure things will get back to normal if this series goes on too much longer. Because that will certainly, I think, play into Kings of Urban's hands the longer this goes on.
Yeah, I think so too. We'll see what the future will bring. The immediate future. 3:30 still left, and that's a very good shot. Very good angle. Fireburner going to try to follow up on this one, but Greasy Maestro saves it. Huge, huge opportunity for Kings of Urban, but they aren't quite able to capitalize on a great pass onto Greasy Maestro. Unfortunately, wasn't quite able to pick up on that either. So both teams getting the opportunities, failing to really make use of them. ELMP is going to try to make something happen here, but I think he just blew away all of his boost on the way to that ball and then didn't have it to try and make an actual play. Jacob going to try to carry this ball all the way through to the air and then position himself for a rebound off of the wall. With Supersonic Avengers defense quick on the trigger, preventing that one from happening. I cannot overstate just how close and how eye-to-eye these two teams are right now.
No, this has been a very, very competitive series. It's only going to keep up, and Greasy with a critical stop there. But yeah, we are seeing exactly why these two teams are so evenly matched. I mean, it was a big win for Kings of Urban on the EU server in Game 1, and it can only help them as they go to NA in the last two games, or the next two games. Could be the last two games, depending on how Supersonic Avengers does in this game, and if they can finish things up, and how well they respond when they go to the other server.
Yep. After a very action-packed early stage of the game, things have kind of quieted down in the last minute or so. Both teams are struggling to fight for definitive ball control. We did see those huge chances from Kings of Urban. But apart from that, it's mostly been set up play and trying to take control away from your opponent before they can do anything with it. And as it stands right now, we are on course for another crazy overtime. Fireburner not quite getting the follow-up on that one. ELMP not the clear that he was looking for. And we see Moses coming in from all the way behind. Going to bounce it off the backboard. What a goal!
What a double-tap sort of goal here that Moses pulls off. We'll try to get a good aerial angle on this. Gets both shots there to end up driving that ball into the bottom part of the net. And yeah, that was going to be very hard to stop no matter what kind of defense Supersonic Avengers threw at it. So a very nice shot by Moses to keep things going here. So 2-1. Now, good position for Kings of Urban. If they can hold on for another minute and a half, then they're going to be in a great spot moving to NA.
Now you can immediately see, though, how Supersonic Avengers just ramps up the pressure. They think, all right, they've got one on us. Let's throw everything up front. Let's try to take this into overtime or even take it in the end still. We're going to have to play this very aggressively, and they are doing this right now. 1 minute and 20 seconds, they do still have to try and even this back up. Will they be able to do it, though? Kings of Urban certainly not going to let go of the pressure.
Yeah, they've proven they only need 4 seconds in order to tie this up. So one goal is not a big lead for Kings of Urban.
Oh, and the LMP going to put this off the backboard. Going to try to follow this one up, but doesn't quite get it. Wrong touch, unfortunately. Just sends the ball wide towards the corner and then upwards arc. And Jacob going to try to carry this one himself. Greasy Meister not quite getting the clear. They have to get a wide clear now. They just have to get the ball up front and see what they can do with it. Once they get it.
Oh, no!
Nice throw! With the own goal. I think that's the second one from Supersonic Avengers this game.
Yeah, it looks a little bit like it. Fireburner kind of putting that ball, trying to put it behind, and Maestro ends up turning right into it to help drill that into the net. That is a disastrous sort of finish for Supersonic Avengers. So, I mean, once we change to the new server, I think what they're going to have to do is just get out of their own head. It seems like they're just getting a little caught up in where they are and what they're up against.
Oh, Crazy going to try to do a Moses, and he does! What a goal!
There is a nice goal. Good response to try to answer back to a definitely not the sort of goal they wanted to get initially for Kings of Urban, but a good response to help tie this game back up or close it, at least close this gap a little bit and put them in a strikeable position to potentially tie this game up. Again, all they need is 4 seconds.
In this game alone, we've seen Supersonic Avengers score 4 times. And the score, of course, is 3-2 in favor of Kings of Urban, so make of that what you will. Oh, and Meister going to try to carry this one in. Will Fireburner be able to block it? Oh, this is so dangerous. Greasy Meister going to try to tap this one in. Maestro tried to get a touch on that as well, but finally Kings of Urban were able to get that ball out of the danger zone with 10 seconds left on the clock and the ball in momentum towards Supersonic Avengers' goal. Can they get another buzzer beater? Here they go. Ball goes back up front. Can they make it happen here? Fireburner up into the air. The ball goes. Greasy Meister is going to try to go for it. Jacob putting it towards the ball. It's going to hit the ground there. No buzzer beater this time. And Kings of Urban extending their lead.
A big, big pair of wins for Kings of Urban right there. On the EU server, exactly what they needed in order to really establish themselves, and now they could pull off something utterly shocking. If they can manage to, you know, come onto the NA servers with the same kind of dominant showing that they had in these last two games, they're not really dominant so much, but just, I guess,
clutch. We're shifting over to Europe now. Europe servers. Started the game off on NA servers, I believe. So we're switching over to Europe now, and the next map is going to be Urban, as it seems. Urban Central. So, yeah. Supersonic Avengers, they have a bit more going for them right now. So they are playing on home turf. They were playing on NA, and they put up such a great performance already against Kings of Urban. Let's see if that little extra ping is what it takes for them to be able to overcome their opponents. Or I guess extra ping is the wrong term here, because they actually have less ping.
Just the better ping, I guess that's what it comes down to. The more beneficial server situation. So, my mistake, I thought we were on EU. Shows what I know.
Not that bad, though, because you can see that the pings from Kings of Urban are actually in a pretty good spot. I mean, 100 isn't that bad.
No, all things considered, and they're a good enough team that, you know, a slight difference like that might not be a big deal, but they are dealing with Supersonic Avengers, who, you know, are a very respectable team in their own right.
As shown here, starting in the first 15 seconds, with a huge attack, here comes Moses, quick to follow up, and the game just continues to be crazy, crazy, crazy. Will Kings of Urban be able to get that third point of the series here? Fireburner. Looking to get it towards the goal here. ELMP does block it, tries to pass it over to Greasy Meister, but Moses saw that one coming, interferes quickly. Jacob looking for the quick follow-up and momentum goal, but missed that ball. Still is on the orange side right now, so they can try to keep it going. Moses putting one onto target, but Meister saved it. With the elbow, two of his teammates, they were pretty much all bunched up in the same spot.
They threw every car they had at trying to stop that shot, because that was going about as far to the far right post of the net as they could get to, and they do manage to shut that one down. But a good early start to this game. Exactly what I think Supersonic Avengers wants, but they need a little more offensive pressure now that they have the server advantage.
Yeah, that much is true. Still a lot of time in this game, though. They can make it happen. They certainly started it off very strong with the defense from Kings of Urban. Just so on point here as well. They're getting the blocks as soon as they need to, but finally one goes through the cracks as Greasy Meister scores.
Yeah, they had very good defense. Like you said, it was looking very nice, but unfortunately right there was enough for Greasy to put that away. Fireburner could not react in time. That ball was moving just too quickly. And unfortunately, that's going to allow the opening score past them. So good move for Supersonic Avengers to finally get on the board early. And might be enough for them to build some momentum. So we'll see if Kings of Urban can actually respond. If they can respond quickly, then we know we're going to be in the same kind of situation that we were in last time.
Yep, absolutely. And I mean, the series lead right now, Kings of Urban 2-0. It could have gone either way, honestly, especially after that overtime in game number one. These teams are so even and close to each other in terms of skill that both of them would certainly deserve the win. Right now, Kings of Urban looking for some offensive here. Meister going to try to carry this one through to the other side of the field. Going to bounce off the corner where Moses were already waiting to clear the ball away. It's going to go right in front of the goal where ELMP is already aiming for it. All he can do is put it against the crossbar. Quick counter opportunity for Kings of Urban, but Greasy Meister prevented Jacob from putting that one all the way through. They carry it just across the backboard. No opportunity to kind of thread the needle there for Kings of Urban. So Supersonic Avengers remain in the lead. We are approaching halftime here.
Yeah, just halftime off the clock. Only one goal in, so it's all coming down to the typical kind of offense we get out of Supersonic Avengers compared to some very strong defense from Kings of Urban. And they've managed to get one goal past, but now Kings of Urban just needs to put something away. And the few chances they're getting are just, they're decent, but they still have yet to be able to break past.
They're doing one after another right now. If you do at first fail, then you're going to try, and try again. I think that code goes a little different. If at first you don't succeed, that was what it was. You try, and try again, and they are certainly doing that as they are getting opportunity after opportunity. This one's off the goalpost as well. Meister with a big chance to try and dribble it in.
Passed
it over to ELMP, but he just narrowly missed that shot there. Didn't quite get it in the angle he was looking for. But that would have been one hell of a high momentum play from Supersonic Avengers.
It certainly would have been. I mean, they responded to that rebound very nicely. They played it forward, almost had a good back and forth, and it just clipped that post, which is a bit of a heartbreaker for them after such a nicely developed play. But the pressure has not really let up. They broke past, and it kind of hung around at midfield for a bit, but they already turned it around again. And now Kings of Urban, you know, they're struggling a bit to really apply some consistent offensive pressure, and that might end up being the big advantage.
Jacob, and this one up for ELMP. Off of the backboard, there for the taking.
Yep, good response to that defensive stop by Jacob, but then ELMP just manages to flick it down from above. Relatively easy goal, all things considered. He just had a good opening there to take advantage of, so nice play on the part of ELMP to be at least aware of where that was going, and now they're on the attack yet again from this kickoff. But
ELMP almost scoring yet again. Another drive-by in the defense of Kings of Urban, kind of falling apart here. Supersonic Avengers in the lead with 2 points. Fireburner gonna pass this ball up front, try to make something happen here. They got 50 seconds to score two more goals. Supersonic Avengers has all the chances that they need. Kings of Urban kind of struggling to really get up front in the past minute that we've seen them play. And ELMP again. He's just so huge right now in the offense for Supersonic Avengers. Moses is going to try to carry this one all the way in with ELMP, showing that he is also a great player in the defense, there where he is needed. And 30 seconds remaining. Kings of Urban looks like they are going to drop their first game in the series.
Yeah, unless they can get something put together here and then maybe come back late in the game the same way Supersonic Avengers did a few games ago, then yeah, they might have to regroup, come back into game four, and hopefully not let Supersonic Avengers tie this series up.
Yep, 5 seconds remain. This is all but lost for Kings of Urban. ELMP going to try to score again, but there it is. Supersonic Avengers getting a score on home turf. Will we see a buzzer beater goal? They're going to keep the ball up as long as possible because rule number one.
Yep, let the ball touch the ground, but unfortunately that one will touch the ground. And Supersonic Avengers getting on the board here. So
it always touches the ground eventually.
Eventually.
That's the way of life.
We've seen some pretty good, some very solid rule ones in my time. But in this particular case, yeah, it is just very well dominated there. So good showing by Supersonic Avengers, getting back into this game, back into this series, taking advantage of the server swap. And, you know, again, we're in the same position where we need a team that's going to break that cycle. I really think that's what all it's going to come down to, is they got to break the cycle of winning on their home server. They've got to win on an away server to build some serious momentum going back to their server. Like, if Kings of Vermin can win here, then they've got a lot that they can take going into the server swap that'll happen again. But if they lose, then we might as well just keep going back and forth.
Oh!
Yeah, that was a big shot there.
Yeah, it's a quick offense coming in from Supersonic Avengers here. The Kings of Vermin are gonna have to take this game, or they will give Supersonic Avengers a lot of room to try and take the series over them. 30 seconds in, we already saw them start this game off pretty offensively, but now Kings of Urban is looking for the push. Fireburn not quite able to block that ball, just kind of backflips it into place, but Beauty Meister coming in from behind actually wins out the 50-50. In the end, ELMP still the last bastion, does get the clear up front, does get Supersonic Avengers into a good position yet again. Here comes Moses with a wall hit, though. And it's a bit of a back and forth right now between both these teams.
Yeah, they're playing tight along the wall, not getting a ton of chances on net. As I say that, a good shot on net that Fireburner has to deny. So a few chances coming in, I will say. Well, a few, but most of it's just being played along the wall and playing at midfield there. You know, kind of in that feel-out stage, trying to make sure they don't overstretch themselves, overcommit to anything, and leave themselves wide open. But we're seeing just some decent play on both sides of the ball, and that's why we are almost a little over a minute in, still nothing on the board. And yeah, not much else to say at this point until one team gets an advantage. But speaking of which, wide open net.
Wide open net indeed.
Yeah, we can see again that commitment, that overcommitment by Supersonic Avengers just allowed Fireburner to cut it off at the pass and put it away. He got that just good positioning on his part to, you know, shut that play down and take advantage of the fact that they had thrown three cards forward.
Yep. Can't overcommit against a team like Kings of Urban. They will make you pay for it, and that is just what they need in a low-scoring game such as this. Oh, what a clutch save right there. Went between Moses and Jacob there for a couple of times before ultimately out of the net, away from the goal line. Very close call there for Kings of Urban, but they remain in the lead, and with how even of a game this has been so far, one goal, again, might be all that they need to get the chokehold onto Supersonic Avengers. Let's see if it can happen. That's a big defensive blunder. Unfortunately, Jacob was still in a good position to block the shot that was going to come in from ELMP. So still no equalizer from Supersonic Avengers. KOU is going to have to hold on to this. Moses just flying past that ball, getting control wide on over to Supersonic Avengers. Fireburner doing his best to block that shot, but this one's almost going to go out in front of the goal. Jacob in a nice defensive position. Blocks the ball. The LMP going to try to dribble this one and potentially pass it over to Maestro. Ooh. They almost get it. Bounces off the goalpost. Supersonic Avengers certainly ramping up the aggression. Oh, yeah, and again, Maestro with a shot.
They are pulling forth whatever they can here. They know time is going to be their enemy here. The sooner they can get that tying goal, the better. And just not let Kings of Urban respond. And they're doing a good job of preventing them from getting some decent attempts. But as I say that, here comes a shot. Goes a little high, nobody back there to help respond to it. Usually a very typical play there for most teams, playing the ball high off the backboard and setting it up for a rebound, but unfortunately, nobody there to actually respond to it.
Yeah, gotta have someone there. Bit of a mess there as Jacob and Fireburner and ELMP were all going for that same ball, just flip-flopping and backflipping back between them. And Fireburner and Jacob again going for the same ball on the defense just to make sure that it gets really cleared, but resulting from that, they failed to get a really wide clear. Interestingly, Supersonic Avengers actually conceding that ball to Kings of Urban, looking for the counterplay, it seems. They still need that equalizer, and they need it soon, so they're going to have to apply a bit of pressure as soon as they can and look to clear the ball away wherever they can. And Jacob knocking the ball against Dreezy Meister, prompting to save out of the Moses with a wall hit. It's a little wide on the angle. And here comes Meister driving up the wall. They are failing to get the ball out of their own half of the field, which is definitely not something that you can keep letting happen against a team like Kings of Urban, because I'm going to make you pay for it. And Jacob almost with the opportunity. Unfortunately, it's a bit too slow to be able to get to that ball. Meister bouncing it on his roof, Greasy Meister trying to pass it back over to him, using his trunk, but with the minute mark hit, this one's going to go in off of the wall!
Maestro, big goal here. Fireburner gets a little caught up on the wall trying to play this forward, and Maestro responds to it and just gets that distant shot, all he needed to get that critical late-game tying goal. And with the way this scoring and the way the offense has been, that very well could carry all the way to overtime, just with what we've seen so far this game.
Yeah, it hasn't been a high-scoring game at all. Certainly less scoring than the previous one we watched. But who knows, maybe both these teams have been saving their last bit of steam for the final few moments of the game. Might still see a goal.
All it takes is just one more. Just one little goal, squeeze that one pass. You only need 1 second to put a goal away. Heck, you don't even need that.
Oh, Maestro with a chance! As Jacob misses the clear, but unfortunately Maestro misses the shot as well. That was about as good as it's going to get for Supersonic Avengers. Here comes Greasy Meister, though, putting it off the backboard. Maestro there for the follow-up, puts it towards the wall. Supersonic Avengers certainly ramping up the pressure in the final 10 seconds of the game, but this is looking like it is going to overtime.
Very well could, but we're coming down to the final 0 second time here, and it will hit the ground, so overtime it is. 1-1 score. No big surprise with what we've seen out of these teams so far. The second overtime game between these two teams. There's a great shot off the wall, and immediately... Immediately, Jacob puts an end.
Taking Supersonic Avengers into the chokehold now. Now they're going to have to win their next three games in a row to still have a chance at semis. And this kind of looks very familiar to the first series that we've watched tonight.
Yeah, this is a big advantage, though, for Kings of Urban. They took a game off of their away server, so to say. And that is... just critical, like absolutely critical for their success, and a really big indicator of just what kind of team we may have here with Kings of Urban, quite frankly. Like that, this is just some huge performance on their part, and now they're in a great position now because we're going back to NA. They've only got to win one more game, and they're moving on.
Yep. That's all they need. That's all they need to move on and get a shot at that prize pool. Speaking of prize pool, we are still and will be throughout the entire evening adding every single cent of every single donation that comes in directly towards that prize pool. So if you want to see your team win big, then hit that donation button and toss in a few coins of your own if you want to support your favorite team. We're almost hitting 3,000 there, so that is awesome. You guys, this community is just amazing. I cannot overstate how grateful we are to have such a supportive and amazing community. But yeah, coming into the next matches, we are back on U.S. turf. That's going to be certainly a bit of an advantage for Kings of Urban. All they need is one more game to advance to the semifinals, and making it an EU versus NA semifinals, which is probably what most of the people were hoping for. But
yeah, that's
certainly
their advantage if they can get to it. And we'll take a look at the bracket when we are all finished up here and see just how everything is starting to shape up, because we've got two more quarterfinal series to go, and then of course we will dive into the semifinals and see just who will be playing for that very nice prize pool, at least the lion's share of that very nice prize pool, whatever it may be when the day is all said and done.
Yep, absolutely, but as we begin the game in the first 20 seconds, again, a hot opportunity. I think we haven't really talked about this enough. Yes, Kings of Urban is up 3-0, but just look at the way these games have been going. They could have gone either way. It could just as well have been Supersonic Avengers up 3-1 right now in the series. This is not Kings of Urban walking over Supersonic Avengers by any stretch of the imagination. It's just... I don't want to call it chance, of course, but I'm just going to say that this series could very well look exactly the opposite right now. Big, big save coming in from Maestro there, preventing an early lead for Kings of Urban.
Yeah, I think a lot of it comes down to what has been very clutch play out of the part of Kings of Urban, and it's something that they're really well known for. We saw a lot of this during their series in the Pro League against Untethered. A set of very close games that actually ended 4-1 in their favor.
But
there's a big wide open net. They're not going to be able to do it if they're leaving their net wide open like that. Maestro just sees this opening and takes advantage of it. And that's really all she wrote. I mean, nothing there. Relatively easy shot. Just good positional play by Supersonic Avengers to put away that goal.
Yep. Part one is seeing the opportunity. Part two is taking care of it. Nicely done! Great save coming in from Greasy Meister Jacob's. Going to try to go for the follow-up there. Actually puts it onto target and Moses! Adding that huge extra momentum that goes for the equalizer.
Abrupt response after a great save, but Jacob plays this ball to the corner, and then Moses just redirects it in a great position to help tie that up. And we are in a tied game yet again. No surprise here. I don't think there's any real shock at that.
Unbelievable, this match. I wish it would never end. This one's going to go off the backboard. Greasy Meister trying to follow up this up himself. Meister gets a shot off, but it also hits the backboard there. Went a bit too straight for that one. Gave it too much upward momentum. Would have been a nice shot onto target. Supersonic Avengers quickly trying to shift momentum back into their hands. Trying to keep the play going. It is what they have to do. They are in the chokehold right now by Kings of Urban. They have to win this to still have a shot at the semifinals. Crazy Match are going to try to pick up on the pass. Beautiful team play from Supersonic Avengers.
Really outstanding. Look at this beautiful aerial setup here by Maestro. Before it even hits the ground, Greasy with a great finish puts that shot away. I mean, that's just nice aerial play on the part of Supersonic Avengers, taking advantage of whatever little opening they could get. And a lot of effort going into that goal. Well played, and that's going to give them the lead here. Still tons of time left, though. Much more offensively minded game between these two teams here in Game 5.
Yeah, it's like the momentum or the general pace of the game just switches around as wildly as the lead does. One moment they're doing it a bit quieter, the next moment they just go all out, balls to the wall. Unbelievable stuff that we're seeing here between these two teams. This is such a fun game to watch. We're going to see another chance with Supersonic Avengers as the LMP knocks it next to the goal. Another shot up forward from Maestro. LMP going to try to pick up on this one. This one's going to bounce onto the ground. Greasy Meister almost certainly going to go for the aerial. Bounces off the wall, passes over to Maestro. It's blocked by Jacob and off onto the backboard it goes. Nice offensive play from Supersonic Avengers playing out their chances here. But Kings of Urban still able to keep the pressure low enough that the goal does not quite happen just yet.
Yeah, we're seeing Supersonic Avengers do a very nice job of shutting down these offensive plays from developing. And oh, there's a nice redirect, but no, it's stopped by Jacob. What a crazy stop. I don't believe that he stopped that one. Unbelievable, but they're keeping this going. You can see every attempt that Kings of Urban gets to try to clear this out is getting turned around almost immediately, so they're going to have to strike quickly.
Greasy Meister missing that wall hit. Jacob just narrowly touching that one. Fireburn's going to try to angle this one in with Maestro, flipping it up front where Moses is already waiting for the block. Kings of Urban going to have to make something happen in order to tie the game back up. Fireburner passing it straight over to ELMP where he was already waiting. But he just passes it back, and so Fireburner finally can make his push forward. Jacob waiting for that ball, going to try to get it past the defense, doesn't quite make it. And there's the wide clear from Greasy Meister. Supersonic Avengers, time is on their side right now. Can they keep this up? Demo by Maestro taking on Jacob, and that's a big chance for Fireburner. Puts it against the crossbar. Here comes Jacob with another shot off of the backboard. Moses is waiting for this one, but the LMP was going to get it before him. And Fireburner blowing up Greasy Meister in frustration, I believe.
Probably so. Oh, there's a nice setup there, but no. Again, so many chances for Kings of Urban that are going just slightly too wide or getting denied at the last moment. And already the ball's been flipped around, but they can't let that ball spend too much time on their side of the pitch right now.
Oh, Greasy Meister lopping it over to LMP, not quite able to finish up on it. But another big, big opportunity in the final closing moments of the game for Supersonic Avengers, Kings of Urban. They are running out of time fast here. Another shot onto target from Greasy Meister gets saved by Moses. Meister winning out the aerial 50-50, and Fireburner finally going for it, passing it over to Jacob, but puts it towards the goal, into the general direction. Back into the corner it goes, where Moses is waiting for it, puts it up in front, but the defense from the SSA is already waiting and ready. With 5 seconds left, can Kings of Urban take it into overtime in the final closing moments of the game? It doesn't look like it. There we go, Supersonic Avengers. That's 1 out of 3.
Yeah, that is, again, a big response. Getting credit on the proper server, or at least on the server that they need to respond on. So both teams getting critical wins that they need and kind of counteracting one another. But in any event, that is precisely what they needed to get done, and I don't know. There's not much else to say here. These two teams are so evenly matched and have been coming into this series back and forth consistently that it is, quite frankly, just shocking how evenly matched these two teams are. I thought we would see a big clash of styles here, but we're really not so much. Or at least we're seeing different styles, but they're being counteracted so nicely on both ends.
Here we go. Game number six. We might take this one all the way to seven, folks. Would be the first game, the first match of the day, but certainly, I believe, not the last.
Still match point.
It is, and oh, so close, Crazy Meister. First 15 seconds, again, it's an ever-repeating story. Supersonic Avengers getting an early goal in, and they're doing their best to defend it all the way through. Kings of Urban still have the chance to swipe Supersonic Avengers off the face of the tournament with just one win, but Supersonic Avengers, they're going to fight as hard as they can.
Yeah, Supersonic Avengers definitely capable of getting these two last-second critical wins that they need to bring this series all the way to Game 7 and then shut it down there, because they will have a decent little advantage.
Oh,
it goes that far, but that one!
Direction. And that's the first goal for Kings of Urban.
Yeah, that one squeaks away. We can see this ball played to the corner. Fireburner gets that little shot off the front end of his car, and that's all it takes to put that shot away. So, nicely positioned on the part of Fireburner to cut off that angle, and just manages to break past everybody. But I think Kings of Urban really wants to build up a few goals here, get some momentum behind them, and just establish a nice dominating presence on this server to, you know, prove that they are a very strong and effective team here.
Strong and effective they certainly are. They haven't even made it this far in the first place. Fireburner gonna try to get another one in. Gets saved by Maestro here. Supersonic Avengers finding themselves under heavy attack here in the early stages of the game. Fireburner not getting the touch. LMP blocks his path. You ain't getting through here, boy. And so he prevents him from angling that shot in. But Kings of Urban, they're just gonna keep the pressure up as far as they can possibly make it go.
You can see Kings of Urban trying to play a little more physical game, which could be a very positive thing on their front if they can do it well. And there's a big demolition on the part of the LMP. I was following Jacob for a bit, and we saw him try to charge the goalie, but it didn't quite work out. There's a decent setup and just collision there on the part of SA, but it breaks it up.
Yeah, they're going to be lucky that nobody from Kings of Urban was in a good position. Everyone misses that ball. It just goes straight through a barrage of cards going for it. 3 minutes still left for Supersonic Avengers to try and tie this one up. It's a lot of time. They just have to find their stride. They just have to get that momentum on their side. Once they have the aggression going, they generally keep it up very well, but getting it going is the difficult part. This one might be a great setup for ELMP, though unfortunately doesn't quite get the angle I was looking for, puts it next to the goal. And that is going to be ball control back in the hands of Kings of Urban. We're going to make quick use of it, force the save out of Maestro. Jacob's going to keep the ball on the orange side of the field and try to keep the play alive for as long as possible. Good clear from ELMP, immediately gets blocked by Moses. Kings of Urban are really, really looking to take it this game.
Yeah, both of these teams doing such a good job of shutting these offensive plays down. If you just see how everything starts to develop and immediately Supersonic Avengers reads it, kills it. Same thing on the other side of the ball. Things start to develop, they get red, and it gets shut down. And that's why we are seeing such a low-scoring game, low-scoring set of games, quite frankly, between these two teams, because they're not letting plays happen. And that's the best possible defense you can play.
True that. Up into the air, the ball goes. Both these teams are just so awesome.
They really are, and it's a shame that they're both one of these two teams is going to be out here in the first round, and that's really unfortunate, and just knowing what we know from these two teams. But it's got to happen, and this would have been a hell of a final, but we get it in the very first round.
Yeah, absolutely. Here we go, 1 minute and 30 seconds left for Supersonic Avengers. They're going to have to make this happen. They're going to have to tie the series up. Or they are out, but this is a great setup on the LMP. Unfortunately, Greasy Meister not quite quick enough to react on it. Onto the other side of the field it goes. Greasy and Moses both driving past. It's going to lead that save for Jacob. ELMP going to try to play it off in front of the goal. They need a good opportunity, and they need it fast. It's been something that they've been lacking so far. Greasy Meister knocking it against the ball, pinching it in place for Maestro, who just narrowly misses the shot. 1 minute still remaining
for Supersonic Avengers to try and tie this back up. Can they make it happen? Maestro will get a shot here. Can he get the right angle? No, he cannot. ELMP with the follow-up. This one's going on target. Gets saved by Moses. And with every passing second, the situation just gets more and more dire for Supersonic Avengers.
It's getting hairy. It's really getting hairy. Time is their worst enemy, but they have been very effective at the late game. So they might be able to squeeze something out here.
LMP with a chance. No Maestro on the wrong side of the ball. 30 seconds now remain. And Kings of Urban are on the offense. They're going to get a goal here if they don't prevent Fireburner from dribbling it in. They do, but Kings of Urban keeps the pressure up. 10 seconds now left for Supersonic Avengers. This might be the final 10 seconds of the Pro League for that team. They've had one hell of a run, but the ball's going to touch the ground, and that is going to be Kings of Urban advancing into the semifinals to play against Crown and Jewels, I believe.
You know, I think they're on the other side of the bracket, but we will double check. We're going to look at this bracket once we're done here and just see what we've dealt with. But either way, a narrow, narrow win for Kings of Urban gives them, just quite frankly, all they needed to move on here. So, very impressive start to this tournament. We've got an NA team that has moved forward. Some people, myself included, kind of thought that the EU's teams would run the show, but I think we're going to be very surprised by what's turning out here. And Kings of Urban just fighting tooth and nail, plain and simple, just fighting tooth and nail to make that happen.